Okay guys, well the first thing I did was I just took these little sliding racks off, and you can see they just had tabs that made them basically pop out of here really easy. So as you can see, you know, this thing's pretty much gutted, and as you guys can tell, there's pretty much a frame in this filing cabinet that is perfect for our stove, because I literally need that exact size right there, right where that bar is right where I'm going to cut just behind it. So I have a solid frame that this thing is going to be built around, which is perfect. It's going to be a lot more stronger than just, you know, a couple pieces of steel bended around. I mean, it's actually got a solid frame to it, and, you know, on the sides and on the top. So I'm really, really excited about this thing, and I think it's going to work great. So I think the next thing to do is I'm just going to go ahead and cut below here and then get started with the 10 snips making my cut around. Okay guys, well I marked my lines and I basically cut those lines as good as I could, as you can see. And the idea is this is going to be our front. I'm going to use the opening of the drawer to create my door. And this side over here is going to be folded down to create the bottom onto that bracket frame support. Basically what I'm trying to figure out now is just how to cut out some of these angle brackets so that way I can bend this thing over and rip out these two sections the way I want, and we'll be well on our way to getting our stove made. So I guess the next thing you need to do, I need to figure out how to cut these brackets and take these two panels off. Okay guys, it's a new day, another little bit of work on this stove or this filing cabinet. All I did was, since you guys last saw it, just cut this section with the 10 snips, this with a grinder, and then I actually took out this whole back frame, which you see up front. I took that out. All that holds this in is spot welds, so I just took a chisel and banged it out from underneath. So I took that whole frame out, and then I just got rid of this panel over here, which you can see. And then I also took the door off one of the drawers, again, spot welds, so I could just pop that off. And that is going to be the door for my stove. So hopefully you guys get the idea. The next thing is we're going to try and cut this bracket or this support right here and get this out, so that way we can actually fold this whole side over, and this will create the bottom of our stove, or the top, I haven't decided yet. And then I'm going to get this welded together, and then we're pretty much going to be very close to being done. After that, we're just going to cut the hole for the stove pipe and mount our door and figure out our air system on how we're going to let air in and out, and we'll be done. So I guess the next step, I'm going to go ahead and cut this part and then get this folded over. Okay guys, so I took that part of the support out, grinded out that section, just popped out the spot welds, and then I took off a little bit of added support right here. I took that off, and as well I took this off, and then I flattened it all out except for right here. So basically now I have two tabs, which are basically about an inch strip of this is going to be folded down up here and here to create a spot for the bottom to go into. So pretty much that's the next step, is going to be to fold these tabs down, and then we're going to fold the bottom up. Thank you. Not
okay,
too bad,
everybody. Not too bad. So I just finished folding over to make our tabs on these sides, and it turned out really good. All I did was just took the pliers, and at my line I just made a fold until it creased the metal, and then I just came back and took a board, slipped it up under there to use as a backer, and then just tapped it a little bit. Just like that. You want to be careful you don't cut your hands doing this stuff. That's why I'm wearing leather gloves a lot. You want to be careful when you're doing that. So now, pretty much, it's almost done in terms of actually creating the stove. And after that, we have to work on the door and the stove pipe where it enters in. So pretty much what I'm going to have to do next is figure out how to get a clean crease right here. And I'm going to fold this sheet up into these two tabs, cut it to size if I need to, and then I'm going to get it welded, probably just some spot welds. I'm thinking this will probably be the bottom, and I'm going to put a little bit of sand in the bottom, so I'm not going to have to worry too much about smoke coming out the bottom, because smoke rises up, and up here it's not going to come out. It's pretty good and sealed. So especially if I put a layer of sand, it can't even penetrate to where those spot welds are, so it can't even find a leak. So I'm thinking if I do that, I should be good to go. All I have to do next is cut a really nice circle in the top to make sure our stovepipe doesn't leak much, and that's pretty much it. So I'm going to go ahead and clean up these edges a little bit and then figure out how to fold it over, and I'll bring you back. So we got the door already sized and stuff because that's what it came in with the filing cabinet. So this piece is actually off the back of the door. It was like a double walled door. So I'm going to go ahead and use this flat piece to make a slider so we can control our airflow. And then this section right here are going to be two tabs that are going to keep this door in there. It might sound a bit confusing, but you'll see it once I actually get it all installed. So I went ahead and made two cuts here, and I'm going to try and get this to bend pretty evenly, which it didn't the first try. Yep, that's okay. I don't need it that big anyway. There we go. Okay, so we've got, if I can pick it up here, we've got our flat piece of metal that is going to be our slide, but now we need something to hold that slide when it's in our stove. So one of these are going to be tabs that are going to sit on either side, and the slide will be in the middle. So I just cut them out of our plate here, and this side's pretty good, but this side I kind of went astray, so I just drew a straight line with it the size I want. Now I'm going to clean it up. Now that it's off of the main sheet, it's easier to work the metal so I can get a cleaner cut. Or a straighter cut. Alright, anything else that if I want to clean up that little point right there, I can always just grab a file. And then we're going to split this in half. And this will be both sides. Of course, I had to drop this stupid thing again. This will be both sides of our slide holder, and you see it's actually got a little bit of a radius in it already, which makes that fit perfectly in there for later when we attach it. If we get it good enough, we can actually get it to slide freely just in that bevel. So, we're well on our way. Not too much longer and we'll be done. Okay guys, Mason's fingers represent the bolts, and there's going to be two more bolts right here. So these are going to be bolted onto the door, and then our slide is going to be right in the middle, and that is going to be able to freely move. We're going to back these up just a little bit more. So this will be able to freely move, and we can slide all the way out, and we're going to have a hole in the door right here, so that'll let in all the air, and then when we go to sleep that night, we can close that up, and it'll burn all night long. Okay guys, so the next thing we're going to do is we're just going to drill holes, two in each plate, if I can keep them on the table. Don't have to be anywhere particular because we haven't drilled the holes in our door yet. Go ahead and tap two spots. If I kept doing that, I could probably go straight through, but I won't bother with that. Okay. Mason, can you go grab me another battery off the shelf? Guys, we're going to cut out the hole for our door. Got it all marked out. All we got to do is cut it out. Alright, so the next step after we drilled our hole, we've got to put in a slide, which I just showed you guys, cut that out. All I did was I put a really long bolt through there and I put a nut on the backside to help create a stopping mechanism, and then I put a bolt on the front with a lock washer. And that's going to go on here. So the next thing is we need to take our two tabs and we're going to mount them on here just like this. So I'm going to go ahead and take a couple bolts. Slide these through, just like that. All right, that was tight. Alright, so now all of those are tight, and now we have a slide that we can use to control the airflow. And this is actually upside down. I'm going to go ahead and flip it over for you. I just have it wedged in the stool here. Alright, so now this is going to be the right side up. So when we want to control the airflow, we now have a slide door. We want hardly any airflow, so it'll burn through the night. We just open it up just a little bit, and then when we want to get it cranking up really hot, we can open it all the way, and that'll let in a ton of air. So that's what we're going to use to control the airflow. Got a lock washer. Now we got hinges. Okay guys, so we just finished mounting the door. I kind of just want to give you a flyby overhead so you can see the progress. Of course, I got to step over everything in the process. So as you guys can see, the door's mounted. I've got just two hinges on there that are bolted on there. And as you can see, it opens up, and I can actually flip this all the way around if I want to do that. And I can fill it full of wood. And then when I'm done, I can bring it around. The next stage is going to be the latch. I'm going to figure out how I'm going to keep this door closed. And then, depending on the airflow, if I want to burn it all night long, I can open it up just a little bit. If I really want to get it going hot, I can open that airflow all the way. This is definitely a long process. It's taken quite a few hours. I have no idea how long it's going to end up taking. Quite a bit. I still have to do the pipe hole and do a subsystem to hold it up in the air. Whether I just pile it up on bricks or I actually build a stand for it is yet to be determined. But, you know, so far I'm liking the process, the progress, and it's definitely turning out good. I can't wait to use it in the hut. I was, really hoping I could just get someone to donate a stove to me before this winter, but that didn't happen. I emailed a lot of places, and nobody would give me an answer. So, I had to take matters into my own hands and build one myself, and I think it's just as good as anything else I could buy, and there's a lot more pride in it, and it's $200 cheaper. So, I guess the next step will be the latch. Okay, guys. We drilled a hole right there. Now it's time to see if our door idea is going to work. We have an eye bolt, piece of metal that I just put a hole in, and three nuts. So the first we're going to feed the eye bolt through there. Sure, I'll feed this one through. Thought that was going to be a little bit tighter on there. We may have to grab a few washers. So let me go and do that. So we grabbed our few washers. Go ahead and feed those on there. We bottomed out the threads on our eye bolt, so that's why we're having to do this. Gotta move this piece of metal a little bit.
you're gonna have to use all three here. It's not a big deal. Alright. Now that's pretty tight. Which is what we want. Next, we're gonna figure out kinda where this thing needs to be. First of all, I need to kind of see if it's going to even be long enough. I may have to cut one a little bit longer, which is not a huge deal. I can do that. But that's the premise of our latch right there. Yep. We're not grabbing anything, so that's easy enough to fix. All I have to do is go grab the 10 snips and cut a piece just a little bit longer, and then drill another hole in it. So I'll bring you guys back.
Hey guys, so I cut one of those a little bit longer. I'm going to go ahead and move that nut down a little bit more because I know that it's going to be too much.
Okay. And this is a good system in that we can fine adjust it. So that way, the door closes tightly every time. So as you can see now, when we close the eye bolt, or do it parallel with the door, it's closed. And then if we want to open it up, we just turn it that way. So, we're close. Alright, there you go. As you can see, turn the eye bolt, you can open it up, and then when you want to close it up, just turn it like so. Ooh, a little bit more. I think I need to tighten up this thing a little bit. There we go. When you're making stuff yourself, there's always little hurdles you gotta jump. It's not like you're just buying it in a store. Alright. There you go. Pretty nifty, huh? Ooh, too far. It's a bit hard to tell. There you go. I may end up cutting one just a little bit longer, so that way I can kind of know when it's going to close. There we go. There you go. So in one day, I basically bent the stove up, made the door, made the sliding rack for the air, and that thing works great. Nice and smooth. I did the hinges, and I did the latch. I think the only thing I'm going to do next is figure out a way to keep this door from pushing in more, which it really doesn't do it much anyway, so it may not be that much of a concern. That closes it up pretty good like that. So I may be good with that. So that's pretty much it, guys. I'm satisfied with it. This is going to be enough for today. And I guess in the next video, it'll be a second for y'all, but we're going to go ahead and probably live burn it. We're going to get it welded. We're going to burn it. I'm sorry. We probably have to cut an exhaust pipe before we do that. Sorry. So we're going to weld it, put the exhaust pipe on there, and then we're going to do a burn and see how good it does. So we're almost done, guys. Okay, guys, so as you can tell, the stove looks a little bit different from the last time you saw it. Yesterday, I didn't feel like pulling the camera out because I knew it wasn't going to be doing too much. But pretty much all I did was I just cut a hole in the back corner with some 10 snips that'll fit a 6-inch stove pipe. And that's what I'm going to use. I'm going to use the same pipe that I used for the chimney stove. I'm just going to switch out the stove underneath it is all I'm doing. But as you can tell, it's got a lot of crap on it because I burned a fire in it for a couple hours yesterday to get all this paint off. And it did a pretty good job. There's not too much warping, not really any in the top. A little bit on the sides, but that's no big deal. And probably going to be some on the bottom. But when I make the base for the bottom, it's going to be well supported. So I'm not going to have to worry too much about warping on the bottom. So
The next thing I'm going to do is it rained all day today, so it got a bunch of dirt and crap all over it. So I'm going to go ahead and get the power washer out, and I'm just going to spray it off again to get all this excess paint off and to get maybe some rust and this dirt off. And then I'm going to wipe it off. And the next thing that I'm going to do is I thought about welding it, but I don't have welding equipment, so it's going to take some work to get it welded. So I figured the next best thing would probably be some pop rivets. And I picked up some at the store today at Lowe's. And these are 3/16 diameter pop rivets by a quarter inch. And I got some washers to go with that. And so that's what I'm going to go ahead and do to do the bottom. And I might end up getting it welded. And if I do, I'll get that reinforced. And I'll probably weld this pipe onto here to keep any smoke from leaking out there. If I can't get it welded, then I'll just use some more high temperature caulk around there to make sure that that doesn't leak smoke. So that's pretty much it for this part. I guess we're going to go ahead and get this thing pressure washed, get the rivets in it, and then after that it'll probably be one last burn in it, and then we'll paint it and call it done. So let's take it over and get it pressure washed. Okay guys, the bottom sustained a bit more warping than I would have liked to have seen. It was definitely my fault. I burned a really, really hot fire in it with no sand on the bottom for a couple hours with it being on level ground. So it's totally my fault, but I'm not really worried about it because I know as soon as I go and put on a level surface and light a fire in it, hopefully these warps might straighten themselves out a little bit more. If not, whatever, it's not a big deal. I am going to put it on fully supported on its base, so that way nothing will slowly bow out over time. And I'm going to add in a layer of sand at the bottom to help protect this bottom even more. So I'm not too worried about it. It's not a big deal. It's still functional. It's still going to work good. And so I guess some of you might be asking the question, if you just put pop rivets in this thing, aren't you still going to have big gaps for smoke to come out? Yes, but if you think about it, this is going to be the bottom. Smoke normally rises, so it's going to rise up into that pipe before it would seep down below into these cracks. Also, I'm going to add in, you know, half an inch or to 3/4 inch of sand. So it's going to completely cover this crack anyway, so none of this should really have any problem smoking. I didn't see any smoke coming out of these spots yesterday, and it was fully open like that, and I didn't even see any smoke. So I'm really not concerned about it. So the next thing is I'm just going to take this front lip and push it up against there so I know that's where I'm going to be wanting it as my final spot. And I'm just going to go ahead and start tapping my spots for my holes. That one's good to go, and I can always sandwich one in right there to keep that lip from moving around afterwards if I see if there's any more spots like that that happen. Alright, so I put a rivet pretty much every couple inches. Got one here, 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 there, and there. So I got quite a few in here, and that should take the place of welds. If I notice it's going to be a problem, I'll get it welded, but for right now, it's just going to be difficult to get that done. And I like to get this stove done as soon as possible. It's taken a while, and I want to get it finished. So I don't know if you guys can see, I still have some more paint here that needs to be burned off. All the paint back here has been pretty well burned off, so I like that. So I think the next thing I'm going to do is do one last burn in it, and I'm going to try and find a spot that's pretty flat, so when I burn in this thing, it'll hopefully maybe flatten out all these imperfections in it, because you can tell it's gotten quite warped. So hopefully next time I heat it up, I can do it on a flat surface and it'll be nice and flat when I'm done with it. That remains to be seen.
Like I said, if it turns out not to be flat, that's fine. My main concern is I just don't want to burn through it. So if I put a layer of sand there and it just stays warped, that's fine with me. So next thing is we need to do one final burn, get all this paint off, and then I pretty much want to paint it and be done with it. So let's go ahead and get started on that. Let's do another burn. All right, everybody, I know you can't see me. It's thundering and the camera's out in the rain, so I got to get this done pretty fast for you. And here comes the rain. So let me go and get this camera moved inside here before it gets poured on.
This is not the way I like to do things. Yeah, here comes the rain. Sorry about the shaky camera, guys. Doing the best I can. It's thundering and lightning and raining, and I want to get this done today, so. Alright.
So, I'm actually under a little treehouse thing that we've had on our property for a long time. Apparently, my dad built this a while ago, but since it's raining, I gotta let this paint dry in the rain, or in the dry, so. Oh, there's some lightning. Alright. I got all the paint taken off. It's time to paint it again. I got some more high temperature paint. So let's go and get this thing done. Alright guys, well after quite a few hours of work and a lot of sweat and a lot of time, we finally got it done. Looks great. I painted it yesterday and I let it dry overnight and it looks pretty good. Not as thick of a coat as I could have done, but I didn't have much paint left. This is high temperature paint. It's actually meant for wood stoves, so it should work perfect on our stove that we built. So the benefits of this one compared to the one that we had, and this is the main reasons why I replaced it, was this one has a flat top, so you can cook on it. It's much bigger, so it'll burn wood all through the night, so it'll still be going in the morning. It doesn't smoke. It doesn't leak smoke all over the place. And it has an air control system. So now we can control the airflow to determine how long we want it to burn. So, hope you guys enjoyed this. I think it turned out really, really nice. We got a good eye bolt here that we just turn it and the door opens and it reveals the pretty spacious interior of that thing. We have quite a bit of room for plenty of wood and that should help burn all through the night. We just have on the end of that eye bolt a piece of metal that's flattened out. It's doubled over so it gives it some extra thickness. And so when we turn that eye bolt, it turns this thing and there's a lip inside the stove that when we push it in and turn it, it locks in there and it won't come out. So that's what we use to open and close the door. And then we just have some regular door hinges bolted onto the sides here. This one's a bit loose. I'll tighten that up here in a minute. So we have two hinges that we just painted along with everything else. Everything looks black. We painted with everything on it, so it makes it look really nice with everything blacked out. I think it looks cool. So we just got our hinges on there, just bolted them on. And then my favorite part is right here, the air control system. It's just a plate
with two tabs on either side bolted on there, and then we got a long bolt coming out that uses a handle. And so with this thing right here, we can control the intake of the air. So if we wanted to burn really, really hot, we just open it up all the way, and that'll let in a ton of air and get it burning really good. If we wanted to let it burn a lot slower, we just slide this thing over until hardly any crack is shown. In fact, we could probably slide it over all the way, and we do have two cracks or two holes right here, and the lack of seal around the door will probably give it enough oxygen flow. It'll burn through the night, but I'll probably leave it cracked open just a little bit, and that'll help control our burn time. We're also going to install the damper that we've had down there already. We're going to put it in this piece of pipe, and this is just to give you guys an idea. The pipe goes back in the corner, and the rest of like probably 5 feet of pipe is going to go out the shelter. So it's definitely looking good. It's going to fit, I'm hoping, pretty good in the shelter. And in terms of a stand, I'm probably just going to put it on a couple cinder blocks because I want to support it all the way underneath. So I'll probably do 3 cinder blocks underneath it to give it good support. Since the bottom isn't the biggest, isn't the thickest steel, I'm definitely going to add in about 1/2 inch of sand in the bottom to help protect the metal at the bottom. And I'm also going to put it on blocks that are going to support it well, so hopefully it won't bow out over time. That's pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you guys tried it out yourselves. It was a real fun project. It definitely wasn't extremely complicated. It basically took a grinder, some tin snips, and a lot of time, and some hammers and chisels to bang out the spot welds, and you pretty much can make this stove yourself. You don't need a welder, although that would be really convenient. I just used pop rivets, and it worked out just fine for me. So, hope you guys try it out. Hope you guys liked it. And take care, and I'll see you on the next video.